فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
المرتبة الثانية الإيمان، وهو بضع وسبعون شعبة، أعلاها قول لا إله إلا الله، وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق. والحياء شعبة من الإيمان، وأركانه ستة: أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره. والدليل على هذه الأركان الستة قوله تعالى: ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب، ولكن البر أن من آمن بالله، من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين. ودليل القدر قوله تعالى: إنا كل شيء خلقناه بقدر. المرتبة الثالثة.
No. The author, rahimahullah, he brought the second level. We finished the first level. What was it? Al-Islam. We're now moving on to the second level of it, which is what? Al-Iman. Al-Iman in the Sharia, it has two meanings. One is a generic meaning, and it is the religion in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with. هو الدين الذي بعث به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The religion in which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent with is إيمان. الدين الذي بعث به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The deen, the religion in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he sent the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم with. فإنه يسمى إيمان, and it's called إيمان. The second one is a specific meaning, and it is al-i'tiqadat al-batina, and this is when it's the opposite of al-Islam. It is the internal belief. Then the author rahimahullah mentions that the iman has shu'a, branches. The branches are a lot. But the highest of it is what? A'laha. Another riwayah says afdaluha, the best of it. And this one says a'laha, the highest of it. It's qawlu la ilaha illallah, the statement of la ilaha illallah. That's the highest. Wa adnaha, and the lowest of it is imatatul adha anit tariq, removing harm from the path. والحياء شعبة من الإيمان, and shyness is a branch of iman. This hadith has given us that the iman is categorized into three, and you have to memorize this, that the iman is what? It is categorized into three. The first one is aslul iman. The first one is aslul iman, which is the foundation of al-iman. Without it you become a disbeliever. And that is قول لا إله إلا الله. That's أصل الإيمان. Are you with me, brothers? Then the second is كماله الواجب. كماله الواجب. The amount which is obligatory. You're not a disbeliever, but you're a sinner, and you're feared. It's feared for you, disbelief. كماله الواجب. And here the author wrote al-haya, shyness. Shyness is kamaluhu al-wajib. And the last one, which is kamaluhu al-mustahab, the recommended amount. And this is imatatul adha an al-tariq, removing the harm from the path. It's like if I broke your body parts, or I categorize your body parts into three. If somebody attacked your heart, that's the asal of your body, you'll die. If somebody chopped your hand off, that's the wajib, you needed it, but you won't die, you'll still live. And if somebody shaved your hair off, that's the mustahabbat, you just need to look good for the wedding day, right? That's how your body parts are, and that's how the religion of the iman is. The iman has an amount which is asal, without it, no iman anymore, you're gone, you're a disbeliever. And there's an amount which is wajib, and there is an amount which is mustahab, recommended. This hadith is what it's taken from. Each one of those categories, the wajibat are not just haya. Haya is just one of them, which he mentioned in this hadith. It signifies many other branches under there. The asal, there are many other things that fall under it. Are you with me? The mustahabbat, there are many more things that fall under it. Are you with me, brothers? The scholars, they differed amongst themselves, how much is the amount of iman? The hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, it says, al-iman bid'un wa sittun, 60 and odd. The word bid'a is 3 to 9. And in Sahih Muslim, it says, bid'un wa sab'un, 70 and odd. In another riwayah, it says, al-iman bid'un wa sittun aw sab'un shu'ba. Another riwayah says, the iman is what? Bid'un wa sittuna, 60 and odd, or sab'una, 70. The pillars is what the author then mentions after that. When he mentions the shu'ab, he mentions the pillars. The shu'ab are branches. And there's a book written on it by al-Imam al-Bayhaqi. He called it Shu'ab al-Iman. Big book. Shu'ab al-Iman. It's published now by Dar al-Alam al-Kutub. They published it with the tahqiq of Abdullah al-Turki, Shah Abdullah al-Turki, who is, I think, the mudir of Rabid al-Alam al-Islami. He done tahqiq on the book, and he placed on it the ta'liq on the bottom. He brought the Jawahir al-Daqiyah, written by Al-Turkumani on the bottom with his tahqiq. It's published. The pillars of al-Iman is 6. The articles of faith are 6. Al-Tu'mina billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wa liyawm al-akhiri wa bil qadari khayrihi wa sharrihi. There's an amount that's obligatory on each one. We already spoke about the amount that is obligatory when it comes to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Also, there's an amount obligatory when it comes to the angels that everybody has to come with. And it's called al-Iman, that you believe that the angels are khalqun min khalqillah. The amount that's obligatory from the angels is that the angels are a creation from the creations of Allah. And that they are the ones who come down with the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The amount that's obligatory in regards to the books is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent books down. Some, the ones whose names are mentioned, we know their names and we believe in the names, like At-Tawrah and Injil and Zabur and this Quran. And we also believe that the Quran abrogated all the previous books. The amount, والقدر الواجب المجزئ من الإيمان بالرسل, is what? Believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah sent the Messenger to the people. Why? ليأمروهم بعبادة الله, so they worship Allah alone. And the third thing that you believe about the Prophet is what? وأن خاتمهم هو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. He's a seal of all prophets. There's no prophet after him. What you have to believe about the Day of Judgment is, it's the Day of Resurrection, in which every single person will be accounted for every single thing which they did. فَمَنْ أَحْسَنَ فَلَهُ الْحُسْنَى. Anyone who came with good, then he will be rewarded with good. وَهِيَ الْجَنَّةِ, and it is Jannah that he will be rewarded with. جَعَلَنَا اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكُمْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا. May Allah make us from His people. وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ, and anyone who goes wrong and deviates from that path, فَلَهُ مَا عَمِلَ وَجَزَاؤُهُ النَّارِ, then that person will be accounted according to his evil act, and the hellfire will be his abode. You believe, that's what you believe, the amount that you believe regarding the Day of Judgment. The last one, which is believing in the predestiny, the things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destined, is that you believe Allah destines the good and the evil. أزلاً in his infinite knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that nothing takes place illa bimashi'atihi wa khalqihi. That nothing takes place except with his will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the obligatory amount that's needed in terms of iman revolves, it goes back to 2 points. After all that which we said, it goes back to 2 points. The amount that it goes back to is number one, دعوا الواجب ابتداء مما لا يصح دين العبد إلا به. الواجب ابتداء, things that you have to come with from the get-go. مما لا يصح دين العبد إلا به, which your religion is not going to be accepted without it. And the second one is الواجب تبعا, it's the amount that comes after. بالنظر إلى علم العبد بالدليل, with observing the evidences, ووصوله إليه, and it reaching you. نعم.
المرتبة الثالثة الإحسان. ركن واحد وهو أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فلم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. والدليل قوله تعالى إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون, وقوله تعالى وتوكل على العزيز الرحيم الذي يراك حين تكون وتقلبك في الساجدين, وقوله تعالى وما تكون في شأن وما تتلو منه من قرآن ولا تعملون من عمل إلا كنا عليكم شهودا إذ تفيضون فيه الآية. والدليل من السنة حديث جبريل المشهور عن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه قال بينما نحن عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم إذ طلع علينا رجل شديد بياض الثياب شديد سواد الشعر لا يرى عليه أثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذيه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا. قال صدقت. فعجبنا لهم يسألهم ويصدقوا. قال فأخبرني عن الإيمان. قال أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. قال صدقت. قال فأخبرني عن الإحسان. قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. قال فأخبرني عن الساعة. قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل. قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها. قال أن تلد الأمة ربتها وأن ترى الحفاة العراة العالة رعاء الشاء يتطاولون في البنيان. قال ثم انطلق فلبثت مليا ثم قال لي يا عمر أتدري من السائل؟ قلت الله ورسوله أعلم. قال فإنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم.
The author now goes into المرتبة الثالثة, the third level. He finished two levels and now he's going into the third level. And this is مرتبة الإحسان. The level of excellency. The word ihsan in the sharia, it has itlaqani, two usages. Ihsan in the sharia is used in two meanings. Number one, amun, a generic, general usage. And it is the religion الذي بعث به محمد, the religion in which the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent with is called ihsan. The second one is the specific usage and it is اتقان الاعتقادات الباطنة والأعمال الظاهرة. It means to perfect, to strengthen, to solidify your external belief sorry, your internal belief and your external actions. إتقان الاعتقادات الباطنة. It means to solidify your external, internal belief and your external actions. This is called ihsan. The amount that's obligatory and that suffices the person to come with, to be from those who have ihsan, it goes back to two aslaini, two foundations. يَرْجِعُ إِلَىٰ أَصْلَيْنِ. The first one is إِحْسَانُهُ إِحْسَانٌ. The first one is إِحْسَانٌ مَعَهُ فِي حُكْمِهِ الْقَدَرِ. Is that you have إِحْسَان in the hukum of Allah, which is qadari, the universal legislations of Allah. And that means by coming with as-sabru ala al-aqdar, patience upon the predestined matters. The second is ihsanun ma'ahu fi hukmihi shar'i. The second one is excellence in the rules Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislates in the religion. So the first one is hukm al-qadari and the second is hukm al-shar'i. Excellence in the hukm al-qadari by coming with what? Patience. And excellence in the hukm al-shar'i. And that is by doing what? بامتثال خبره بالتصديق إثباتا ونفيا وامتثال طلبه بفعل الفرائض واجتناب المحرمات واعتقاد حل الحلال. Is by believing in that which it tells you, following the obligatory things which it commands you, staying away from the things which it prohibits you from, and believing the halal as halal and the haram as haram. The pillars of ihsan is two. The first one is أن تعبد الله, that you worship Allah. أن تعبد الله, that you worship Allah. The second is أن يكون إيقاع تلك العبادة, that this action occurs from you على مقام المشاهدة أو المراقبة. You are doing it in a manner knowing Allah is observing you subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is observing you and looking at you subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the higher level of ihsan. Some of you might say the first pillar that you mentioned, isn't that iman as well? And isn't that Islam as well? Yes, ihsan is when you've perfected. You're doing the ibadah salah. The salah that you're doing internally and this action of yours are both done with itqan. So it's not just mujarrad ibadah. The second rukun is what? That it has to have as well, is that when you're doing it, Allah is observing you, is the way you're doing it. With those two, it surpasses it. The evidence is that mentioned for ihsan, in which the author brings out two types, adillatul Quran and adillatul Sunnah. He brings adillah from the Quran and he brings adillah from the Sunnah. The adillah he brings from the Quran are two types. ما هو مصرح, that which is direct in praising the people of ihsan. ما هو مصرح بمدح المتصف بالإحسان. The one evidence is that praise the one who comes with the characteristics of al-ihsan, such as قوله تعالى والذين هم محسنون وهو محسنون. That the author brought, those two ayahs that he brought. They are what? In a state of praising. وَمَنْ يُسْلِمْ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ فَقَدْ إِسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. The other ayah after it, which is what? إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ تَقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising them. The second form of evidence is in the Quran. In the Quran is مَا هُوَ مُصَرِّحٌ بِمَقَامِ الْمُرَاقَبَةِ. That which is praised with the station of observation with it. And the author brings the ayah in Surah Al-Shu'ara, الَّذِي يَرَاكَ حِينَ تَقُومُ. And also, إِلَّا كُنَّا عَلَيْكُمْ شُهُودًا إِذْ تُفِيضُونَ فِيهِ. As for the evidence that he used, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُ. The وَجْهُ الدَّلَالَ for it being ihsan is from this angle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who did he praise here? The people of tawakkul, right? And what does tawakkul consist of? It consists of passing your affairs onto who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a person will not be one who passes his affairs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except with what? Except if he worships, Allah in a station where he's observing. مقام المشاهدة والمراقبة. A station where he believes that he's been observed. Then the author, rahimahullah, he brings adillatul sunnah, which is the second evidence that he brought. Adillatul sunnah. And he brought the hadith of Jibreel, which we all know. And this is directly talking about the reality of ihsan, which is that the Prophet said, أن تعبد الله, that you worship Allah, كأنك تراه, like you can see him. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكُ. If you can't see him, Allah can see you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you look at this hadith, at the ending of it, when Jibreel left, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companions, إِنَّهُ جِبْرِيلٌ أَتَاكُمْ يُعَلِّمُكُمْ دِينُكُمْ. إِنَّهُ جِبْرِيلٌ أَتَاكُمْ يُعَلِّمُكُمْ دِينُكُمْ. دِينُكُمْ is Jibreel that came to teach you your religion. The religion here is referred to what? The three aforementioned levels, which were Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. Those three are Islam. That's the deen of Allah. That's why the author said, وَمَعْرِفَةُ دِينِ الْإِسْلَامِ بِالْأَدِلَّةِ. And then within that he mentions the three. It is Islam, Iman, and Al-Ihsan.
الأصل الثالث معرفة نبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو محمد بن عبد الله بن عبد المطلب بن عبد المطلب بن هاشم وهاشم من قريش وقريش من العرب والعرب من ذرية إسماعيل ابن إبراهيم الخليل عليه وعلى نبينا.
The author, rahimahullah, now he finished the explanation of the second foundation, the second fundamental principles. Knowing who was the first principle. What was the first fundamental principle? Ma'rifatul abdi rabbahu, knowing your Lord. Second one is what? Ma'rifatu deen al-Islam bil adillah, learning the religion of Islam with evidence. We're now moving on to the last and final principle that every single body has to know, which is ma'rifatul abdi nabiyahu, the slave knowing his prophet. The amount that is obligatory in knowing the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam specifically, it goes back to four foundations. يرجع إلى أربعة أصول. The amount that is obligatory in knowing the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it goes back to four foundations. Al-Aslu al-Awwal, the first foundation is ma'arifatu ismihi al-Awwal, knowing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's first name, duna baqiyati nasabihi, besides his other remaining names or his lineage. So you know the Prophet that was sent to us and the Messenger that was sent to us, his name is what? Muhammad. The second is what? Is that you know annahu abdullah wa rasuluh, that you know he's a slave and a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which Allah chose him from all of mankind. Allah placed a virtue on the Prophet by giving him risala, messagehood, and that Allah made him the final and last messenger. That's the second. The third thing that you need to have is you know ma'rifatu annahu ja'ana bil bayyinati wal huda wa din al haqq, that you know he came to us with clear cut evidences, he came to us with proofs and with the true religion. Last but not least, which is the fourth one, أَنَّ الَّذِي دَلَّ عَلَىٰ صِدْقِهِ وَثَبَتَتْ بِهِ رِسَالَتُهُ هُوَ الْقُرْآنُ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ. The fourth one is, you know that the Quran has indicated and shown that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam has trustworthiness and has established that he's a messenger from Allah. Those four usul is what everybody has to know about the Messenger. As for the extra part that the author added onto it, which is his father's name, his grandfather's name, and etc., is not obligatory. But the person should know that. They try to know more than the Prophet. But the amount, if you don't know it, that you're a sinner, you're an athim, is if you don't know his name. If you learn that he's from Quraysh and he's Hashim, and Quraysh are from Arab, then this is what you should be coming with. But it's not the obligatory amount. Na'am.
وله من العمر 63 سنة منها 40 قبل النبوة و23 نبيا رسولا نبئ بالبقرة وأرسل بالمدثر وبلده مكة.
The author now goes into explaining that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم عمر 63 سنة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم reached age 63. And in his age, the Shaykh rahimahullah divided it into two. The author divided it into two. 40 qabla an-nubuwah, 40 years of the Prophet's life was before Islam, or before prophecy. It was before prophecy. Wa 20 nabiyan rasula, and 20 he was a what? And 20 he was what? And 20 of it he was a prophet and a messenger. The Arabs, they round down figures. It's 23, don't say 20. That's how they do it. Then the author explained to you that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the wahy, is of two types. Wahy, which is what? Wahy al-nubuwati وَوَحْيُ الرِّسَالَةِ. The wahy, which is prophecy, and the wahy, which is a messenger. And the message, being a messenger, وَحْيُ الرِّسَالَةِ, هِيَ دَرَجَةٌ أَعْلَى مِنَ النُّبُوَةِ, it's a station higher than nubuwa. The Prophet ﷺ became a prophet with Iqra. Iqra made him a prophet. When Iqra came down, he was a prophet. When Muddathir came down, he became a messenger. That's what the author is telling you here. Nubbi'a bi-iqra. He was made a prophet with iqra. وَأُرْسِلَ بِالْمُدَّثِرِ. And he was sent as a messenger, as Muddathir. Because in Muddathir, what does he say? قُمْ, stand up. فَأَنذِرْ, go and warn. Now he's going to go out and embark on work. Whereas اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق was for him to know this. Then the author, rahimahullah, he says, بَلَدُهُ مَكَّةِ. What he means by that is, وُلِدَ فِيهِ, the Prophet was born in Mecca. وَبُعْثَ نَبِيًّا رَسُولًا. And in Mecca, he became a prophet and a messenger. He started his da'wah in Mecca, and then he moved to Medina. The first 10 years, sorry, the first 13 years he spent in Mecca, and the 10 years he spent in Medina. Naam.